So we've already done some test work. So the forecasts are there, the modeling's there. We know that the product will be battery grade. We have to prove it, of course, and we have to cost it. So as part of the, the next stage that we'll be doing over the next 6 months is funding of the project.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Bruce Richardson. He is the CEO of Anson Resources. And Bruce, it's good to see you. How are you?
Very well, thank you, Stephen. Nice to see you.
Yeah, so the company's been out with a couple of interesting news releases in the last little while, and we want to cover off both of them. First off, let's talk. I know that you had some study work done, and that work is showing some very positive attributes. So I'll let you sort of explain what the testing was and what you saw.
Sure. So we've been doing testing with various technologies for a number of years. This is some work that we did with a company called Koch Technology Solutions, or KTS. Koch, as you might know, is a very large company in the United States, second largest privately owned company here, primarily in oil and chemical production. They own very large oil distribution facilities. And what they've done is brought their technology in that industry to lithium industry. So the test work we did, it commenced last August and lasted about 7 months. And the results were much better than what we'd previously achieved. Some of those results we have shown before with different technologies. And those are around about a 98% recovery rate of the lithium from the brine, a 99% rejection of the impurities, the minerals and salts that you don't want are highly rejected, which makes it easier for downstream processing. And something else called a lithium to total dissolved solids, or TDS, ratio of 0.126 on average, and the highest of 0.13. What that means is that the deleterious, or the things you don't want, the impurities that's in the lithium, are easier to process, to extract in the downstream as well. So some of those, most of it's rejected in the initial cycle through the Koch process, but still there's remnants. We have to get to 99.5% purity to make what they call electric vehicle grade. It's very high grade. If you don't get rid of those, then the battery can overheat, etc. So all that means translates into is that lower cost of production from taking the brine through to lithium carbonate, which is very important and a very very high achievement. Koch is very happy with the results, as we are, which shows that the project will be lower cost.
Yeah, and that really led to the next update, which was that you've begun the polishing of this high purity lithium chloride. So maybe you can explain to us what this step is, because it sounds like you're sort of getting the impurities out, if I'm using the layman's term. Am I accurate on that?
That's right. So you have to get to that 99.5. So yeah. Polishing, there's two things you need to do. Once the eluate is produced from the Koch process or any other DLE, you have to reduce the water content and turn it into powder eventually, and also get rid of the impurities. So you do the impurities before you reduce the water content. Otherwise, you're just concentrating your impurities. So polishing means that we take it through in the flow sheet we published. It's very similar to what we've had previously, but with some adjustments. So we take the brine or lithium chloride from Koch. We then put it through nanofiltration and reverse osmosis, pushing out the impurities, reducing the water. Then through a process where we remove any of the minerals, the deleterious materials, which are still left in there, through a couple of different steps. And then you've got a very pure eluate, which is ready for evaporation and carbonation. Right, so you're reducing it down. So the step we're doing at the moment is the polishing. So there's really three steps in the whole process. And after that, there's the evaporation, carbonation, making into lithium carbonate, the final product.
Yeah. So it sounds like, I know there's been a lot of work put into this, Bruce. So it sounds like you're getting towards, I don't want to say the end goal, because it's not that, but it certainly is these stages are really important for you to get to the next stage of this.
Yeah, so we've already done some test work. So the forecasts are there, the modeling's there. We know that the product will be battery grade. We have to prove it, of course, and we have to cost it. So as part of the, you know, the next stage that we'll be doing over the next 6 months is funding of the project. And for that, we need to show test work has been done to a satisfactory level. A bank, you know, approval letter will be required. They probably use independent experts to come in and have a look at what we've done. So theory is theory, but in practice, results are what they look for. So it's very important work, and we know that it'll be successful, but we have to go through that.
Absolutely. Tell me about the lithium market. What are you seeing these days? I mean, the markets have been crazy. The world's been crazy. But what are you seeing in lithium? I know you were at a conference recently. I'm sure it was a big topic of conversation.
It was. So it was a conference in Asia, in Korea, and all the main players from Korea were there, and others from around the world. So not only our business partners, but also LG Energy Solutions, the company we already have an offtake agreement with. And everyone, that was Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So everyone was freaking out, of course, over the tariffs, as you'd imagine what that means. Some of them were looking at, you know, what do we do now? Do we need to manufacture more of our, put more of our processing to get into a battery in the United States? Do we need to invest more? So it really turned heads as it was designed to do. Overall, there's a little bit of work for them to do on how they will go forward with their investment decisions and manufacturing decisions. But as far as the market's concerned, I did see a presentation that was done by Fast Markets, that one of the companies that do analysis on the lithium industry, and it's looking like oversupply in this year, but towards the end of this year they start to see a price increase as people look into 2026 and see that the oversupply is coming to an end. And that's, you know, people always look ahead rather than, you know, wait for it to happen. So there is some movement there, or some anticipation that towards the end of the year we'll start to see lithium prices starting to move again in the right direction.
All right, we'll see what happens for sure. Bruce, thanks so much. Great update, and look forward to our next conversation, okay?
Thanks, David. We'll see you then.
All right, good stuff. Bruce Richardson, CEO of Anson Resources.